Like go get your guap up. Can't like no way I play catch point like nigga going straight to the doctor. And it's crazy how they talk on my gang and they don't put a pen drop time to go pop
up. Ugly
Gotta go. And that red sweater fuck too. My opps, they got no back. Like bitch, and they wasting their money in the stool. And they claiming shoot to get shot. And that situation, shoot got shot. They know we hopped up the V. Miley Van Rick, though, he ran out of sneeze. Lil B, I said, spent through the what? Like what? You okay? We'll give you a wedgie. Monterey and Coast, they link.
Well, USA has the best military in the world. We got the best artillery and the best defensive mechanisms. So there's nothing that this Argentina will be able to do when Jamel Charlo comes to drop them bombs on him.
Nigga, suck my dick. I'ma spend the hell one night. Me and Lottie too deep. I'ma dump the whole clip. And I'm feeling Benty. Star now got troll. Now I got do say till I cop the Henny. Gang, 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 gang. All of my ops, they bombs. Like, go get your guap up. Can't like no way I play cat pulley. That nigga going straight to the doctor. And it's crazy how they talk on my gang. And they don't put in pain. Grab a chop and go pop son. She a cheese and I tell her go mop son. Gang, gang, gang. If they jack an old gang, get the whole dang. Yeah, team, I go give them the rest. These bitches be whole gang and do the whole gang. I don't want that, my only one check. And yeah, we them demons go everywhere. Bump these two, three foes. Don't make it get ugly. I got my gun and my Subi. Shorty a smoochie, she tryna do me. And we done clicked on Zay. Poked up Dre, chased the Ray. But my drillies, we bunny hopping, nigga. I told my little smooth sack the trick. Yeah, I be get crossed off the list. Solo can't pick up a stick. And we still moving senseless. We load that chop, we spin back block. Now they hopping fences. Gang, gang. And we gon' keep running the city. He could get shot if he ballin' like. Like I said, fuck that trip to McKinley. We sit back, feed up, smoke Benji. And all these bitches be treachy. We ain't gon' stop till they free Guap G. Like, that's a op right there. That's a op. Clip that nigga.
Clip that nigga.
Hit that nigga. Told T that don't miss that nigga.
Don't miss that nigga.
They said they gon' spend 2 of your dime. But they don't got poles, so I wanna know how is they really on war time. Gang, gang. They said they gon' spend 2 of your dime. But they don't got poles, so I wanna know how is they really on war time. Like, how is they really on war time? All of my ops, they bombs. Like, go get your guap up. Can't like no way I play catch pull. That nigga go straight to the doctor. And it's crazy how they talk on my gang. And they don't put a pen, grab a chop and go pop son. She a cheese and I tell her go mop son.
It's up and it's late. Ops ain't on shit. I just been a band on some fucking case. They be watching face on with my bitch. Roll 2 grams in my fucking split. Yeah, fact. Let me talk to these niggas a minute. Look, look, we gon' keep spinning and spinning. We be in them foreigns, in the windows tinted. I'd be mad, we winning. Hopping out the car, skiing with them denim. Pussy nigga running, shouldn't never. Pussy nigga running, shouldn't never. Yeah. Niggas be talking a whole lot of skis.
Yeah.
Y'all know what we be. Just drop the low and just watch what you see. Yeah. That nigga KD. I'ma just pop out the cut like. She tryna suck up the whole mic. You can wear J's now, D.O.'s on court like. Niggas be changing they sport like. I swear they used to run track. Now all of a sudden they tough. Niggas be bluffing, they really be racks. Try to show up for a buff. Got them choppers all on the bus. I dare dirty to come. We can't be beefing you niggas, it's bums. Feel busy out of the slum. Bitch.
Bitch, I'm a sloppy steak. Like, I got to drop where he lay. Kick that ass door, put the K to his face. Like, he try to reach it too late. Like, shots getting fired, just open the safe. I'm a demon, I shoot while I chase. And I shoot while I hang over gates. This 32 bulk and this shit leave no trace. Too deep, me and Duck spin an 8. They ain't outside, take a trip to the gate. And I'm like, where they at? Like, I told Dougie, move tack. Blitz through the front, I'ma blitz through the back. Like, we like Kobe and Shaq. He throw 5 on bro, I throw 10 back. Like, just watch how they react. You like Brody was what? You like Brody, what's that? You ran and Wu Lotta get back. Like, he gon' cap for this app. Like, I ain't walking his piece, let it clap. Like, his old ass never relax. Like, and it showed on my what? And it showed on my lap. I keep it sick while I'm looking for drip. Like, especially in sacks. Anywhere I go to be exact. I told Cody Dougie to on sack. Like, most of these niggas, they know what I'm on. They gon' act what they saw me perform. They can't wait till they catch him on what? Oh, let's get it on. We got blue beam glocks, extension with mops. Taxi, Glizzy get drawn. You alright? Something is wrong. He got shot, now his ligament torn. Our first shoot, that's how I was born. He lacking, he snoozing, he snoring. Don't make it hot when you shoot, get up on him. I'ma hop out, sneak, call up on him. Before he look back, I'ma up and throw all him. That's some bro, I'ma throw him on the Fordham. Rape rocking for Monkey, I'm scoring. The bitch, I'm the trimmer for JV, I'm pulling.
DJ, be busy.
JV, I'm pulling.
Boy,
Lucky who said it was not you. Lucky niggas ain't hop on it properly. 80s niggas can't talk about Tali. Choke on a boy, you get put on the molly. Feet do, feet top, feet stink. They really scored on the odds in the paint. And the poor niggas rapping don't do shit. I really put on before I made music. We lost with Diddy, that's what made us lose it. And for yellow, we hopping out booming. I got love.
So I'd say congratulations to Jermell Charlo, who on the second time of trying finally got to be undisputed at 154, a division he's been in since the very beginning of his career. His brother, I believe, also started in that division but moved up to 160. But Jermell has remained in the 154 division and is known subsequently as Little Charlo, as opposed to his brother, Jamal, who is known as Big Charlo. Little Charlo is also known by the moniker Iron Man on Instagram, as opposed to the future of boxing being Jamal. So little differences and separations between the two twins, but they are one when it comes to the support of each other, and it is what it is. However, what I'd like to say is this, is that I was doubtful as to whether Jermell was going to be able to make it, but he did. But I kind of felt that he would, but his state of mind and the way he carries himself suggested that not that Castagna would beat him, but he probably had the tendency to sabotage his own progress. And funnily enough, there is a tweet that suggests that he decided to listen to his trainer on this occasion, and that's why he was victorious. Now, in all honesty, I did watch Castagno again against Lara yesterday, because they put it up as a sort of taster, sort of advertiser for Showtime going into this fight, I believe, or maybe it's PBC, I don't know. I watched Castagno, and he was cutting the ring off Lara. Lara was boxing him. I can't remember how that fight turned out. Did Lara win it, or was it like a? I can't even, because I didn't watch the end result. I couldn't remember. But you know, I was watching it, and I kind of got a little bit bored after a while. You know what I'm saying? Because you know it's a Lara fight, and Lara does what he does. You know, once you've seen it, once you've seen it again. Not seen it again. And it is what it is. Then I watched Castagno on the bag, and he kind of reminded me of Matisse, to be honest with you. These Argentine boxers, you know, is it Argentine or Argentinian? I don't really know which one it is. But anyway, this Argentinian boxer, he was on the bag. It was just very straightforward, no special effects. But hey, he brings the pressure, a bit like the one that brought the pressure onto Keith Thurman back in the day, Diego Chavez, another Argentinian, and of course Marcos Maidana. So you know, it is what it is. They're not great boxers as far as I'm concerned. The only thing that we can probably credit them for is that they probably express a certain amount of grit, and sometimes it can be very, very dirty. I'm not suggesting, of course, that Castagno is dirty, but he got a great deal of support. Now, what I'd like to know, before, you know, let's deal with the superficial first. With all the praise that Jermell Charlo gives to Canelo Alvarez, is Canelo Alvarez going to congratulate him on becoming undisputed second time around? On the second time of trying, forgive me, not second time around, on the second time of trying. I bet if Castagno had won, you know, despite the melancholy feelings, you know what I mean, the feeling of melancholy, I should say, that, you know, that Canelo probably does have, and he's probably going to get over due to his fight with Bivol, you know what I'm saying, due to his loss to Bivol, I think he would have called up Castagno to congratulate him like he did the last time. But you know, despite all the praise and veneration that Jermell Charlo gives to Canelo Alvarez, I doubt very much that Canelo Alvarez is going to pay him any respect whatsoever, because he just doesn't care about those guys. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. You know, you can say whatever you want. I think that the only reason he would do business with PBC and Al Heyman and all those guys is if he absolutely needs to. I don't think he likes them very much. It is what it is. It's just one of those things. I think he sees through the veneer that they like to put up, like it's all about money. You know what I'm saying? I don't think he trusts them. It's a shame, because Al Heyman has a very good reputation with these fighters, but I just don't think he likes them. So you know, it can happen like that. I think that Eddie Hearn has a good reputation with his boxers as well. He plays them on time, he does everything well, but you know, he still has a bad reputation out there, and a lot of people don't like him. So it is what it is. But going back to Charlo specifically, Charlo, he becomes undisputed, and all of a sudden, of course, as they should, some of his supporters, including Errol Spence, are talking about him being placed on the pound for pound list. It's becoming like a moral effort, you know what I mean, something that they like this sort of moral activism that they need to do in support of Charlo to get him on the pound for pound list. And I'm going to suggest, like, you know what, there is an argument against it. If they don't want to put him on the pound for pound list, there's an argument against it. For one thing, like I said, I started this particular commentary by suggesting that he started his career at 154, and he's undisputed at 154. It's taken an enormous amount of time to get there. It is what it is. But within that period, he's taken a loss. And, you know, back in the day, it was okay. You could take a loss. But, you know, you could take a loss if you moved up or moved down. You know what I'm saying? But you've taken a loss and you've taken a draw. You know, it is what it is. Nobody, if you stay in the same division, then you take a loss and you take a draw and you still keep on getting the opportunity to go back again and get there. Because let's keep it real. If it wasn't a PBC show in toto, it would have been a one and done. It would have taken in ages to get another opportunity to get there. It is what it is. But because the whole show is being organized by PBC, it's been allowed to get sort of fast track within that division because they owned the division, just like they sort of own 147, the same thing that they're doing for El Spence right now. So when you see those type of efforts there, you could suggest, like, you know what, they've kind of made it easier for them because it's sort of in-house. It is what it is. I'm not saying that's a bad thing, but when you look at it and you compare it to other people who have moved up, who have moved down, who have actually had to go other places and work with different difficult promoters and different promotional companies and so on, and overcome all those burdens and barriers to still get to where they need to get to. That's why they give Usyk a great deal of credit for the fact that, you know, he has to travel. He's always gone abroad. He's always fought on the road and so on. He's always won his fights on the road. He gets credit for that, you know. Errol Spence gets credit for the fact that he went over to England, you know. But when it comes to Jermell, they're very arrogant with it too. Look at the way he's just dismissed Tim Zhu, saying that, you know, the heat in America fucked him. You know, it is what it is. So when you see all that, when you put that all together, it works against him. And I have no qualms with that. I don't see what he does that's so great anyway. You know what I'm saying? He gets in the firefight with Cass Daniel and he beats the guy, and it took him two occasions to do it. You know, on this occasion, of course, he knocked the guy out. But, you know, eventually, you know, let's give it a buck. It's not like he went over to Argentina to do it. You were in your own backyard. The guy had to travel over to meet you and fight you there, and eventually you won through. It is what it is. So for me, if you want to put money pound for pound, so be it. That's a good thing. If you don't want to, I'm not going to think it's unfair, to be honest with you, after revising it all. But, you know, he's got there. It's a good thing. You know, he's got this humongous chip on his shoulder, like I said. You know what I mean? They're always throwing tantrums. They especially always throwing tantrums. It's a bit off-putting for me. So that's all I have to say about Charlo. Congratulations, nonetheless. It is what it is.
Too official, bitch, I shoot like 10 official. Keep dripping, might need a tissue. Me and Flock gon' piss the missions. If you run, bullets catch up with you. My young boys gon' get up with you. I ain't even gotta send that missile. He rap about guns all day. When we see him, ain't have his pistol. She tryna cuff me, no way, sis. Kick me a Chevy or OA, bitch. They be inside when we on they shit. Fuck all the ops, cause I'm on they list. Red Beam 16s when we on they strip. Police big scene when we lead they shit.
Red Beam 16s when we on they strip. Police big scene when we lead they shit.
Look, it was this bitch for me. Say she only swallowed a kiss for me. No, I ain't getting you none. Look, you was not tricking me. Robbers know ain't no bitching me. Trishas know ain't no kissing me. Robbers know ain't no sticking me. Robbers know ain't no. Cause I move around too proper.
I get around with the glee.
All the bitches we fuck got good doctors. Look,
she went to doctor Miami.
From the back, I'ma fuck up a whole posture. Whole team gon' perform, that's two a good six, roster. Two niggas six. Be acting, they need Oscars. Oscar. Hey, y'all do this thing, I don't need shotters. Nigga, reach your computers to get a bag. Shoot a ops to get a ladder. Can't leave my gun, I be too attacked. They only tow on the internet. He compete, I got too much shit.
Too much.
They ain't fly, I got too much drip. Every day I could take me a pick. Couple ops, gotta go, gotta lift. Hey, y'all.
Big DOA, nigga. Ka, 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 ka. Like, ka, ka, ka. Ka, ka, ka. Hey, ka, ka. Fuck the diss, I'ma act the fuck up. Everything dead, I ain't dabbing them up. Feel the way you get caught the fuck up. Don't lose a rock on me, act in my cup. Try to talk, gotta beat on the scope, that's tough. Like, he ain't going nowhere, I'm showing wherever he run.
Who you call?
I'm a GBG baby, so bitch, I'ma click till it's done. And I love it. If you run, I'ma turn on the front. Outside, no security, bitches, it's me and my gun. I'm the king of New York and I'm still outside making them run. She cut out in the Cardi. Oh, she jacking my bob in the hobby. I like my bitch cakes, I don't like them Bobby. They get active like Ricky and Marty. Tap your head. Nigga Rock got clapped, now he in the Molly. Nigga dead. And I'm tough on myself, no, I don't need an army.
Big DOA, nigga.
See the line, so I'm packing the bitch. Feeling the pressure, I'm blasting the shit. V210, now I'm rocking the whip. He shot it up, but I'm faster with it. It get nasty. Now you coughing on blood, so just that I get active with it. Fuck the diss, I'ma act the fuck up. Everything dead, I ain't tapping them up. Feel the way you get caught the fuck up. Don't do some rock on me, act in my cup. Try to talk, got a beat on the scope, that's tough. Like, he ain't going nowhere, I'm showing wherever he run.
Who you going?
I'm a GBG baby, so bitch, I'ma click till it's done. And I love it. Front, I'ma turn on the front. Outside, no security, bitches, it's me and my gun. I'm the king of New York and I'm still outside making them run.
my mirrors been itching and clapped at. I had a gun in my backpack. Blicky to blicky, run down where that stash at. I paid them hitters through Cash App. Shooters like Mitchell put holes in the snapback. We stopping bodies and trash bags. I bet them hollow tips turn them to hashtags. She a little baba.
So Jerome Ennis knocks out his opponent by the name of Castillo Clayton, and he goes 29-0. There are many people who say that they are believers in Jerome Ennis, and that they've always been believers in Jerome Ennis. Chief amongst them, in fact, is Shakur Stevenson. He said that when they were coming up, he always knew that Jerome Ennis and Tank and himself were kind of set aside and special. But you know, Jerome Ennis is coming up and he's, you know, gaining more momentum, more traction, more attention. Everybody's looking at him and thinking, okay, this is a guy that we need to pay attention to, and he seems like a future champion. It's almost as if it's guaranteed. It's almost as if it's guaranteed. My thing is this, he's got a problem. It's a good problem, I suppose, but it's a problem that could it could go south or it could go north. It could turn out to be a good problem in the sense that it could turn out to be to his benefit, or it could be something that stagnates his career, a bit like what you had with Terrence Crawford. Now, the Terrence Crawford situation is slightly different, of course, because in his case, the reason why I say I'm not too impressed with his knocking out of Castillo Clayton is, for one thing, it is reported that he looked like he was in another weight class to Castillo Clayton in that fight, which would suggest to me that, as we've seen before, he falls into that category of those rather large 147 type of fighters who take advantage of it. And the other thing that I want to say is this, is that, okay, he can box, he looks flamboyant, but the knockout punch that he landed on Castillo Clayton, for me, was borderline illegal. You know, I've been very consistent when it comes to the type of punches. You know, it was quite Wilder-esque, as a matter of fact. But you know, the reason why you're going to ignore it is because ultimately, it gives the people what they want, which is a highlight reel type of knockout. But I think he hit the guy at the back of the head. I'm not sure whether the guy was that hurt. Maybe he wanted out. I don't know. But you know, it's a second round knockout. He feeds into the legacy and the reputation of Jerome Boots Ennis at the moment. And you know, it's good for him, but me, when I look under the hood, when I apply a critical eye to what I'm seeing, I say, yeah, he's great, but you know, I think I've seen this type of thing before. I say it's a good problem because nobody's going to want to fight him because they know not only is he skillful, the fact of the matter is he's not one of those little 147 fighters. He's on the topper, he was on the larger end of the 147 type of fighter. He's not like the 140 guy coming up to 147, or you know, like the others did, like the Danny Garcias or the Terrence Crawford, as a matter of fact, all the way from 135. You know what I'm saying? That's a journey. But you know, he's at the top end of the 147 division, and those guys tend to hang around a little bit. I mean, like Keith Thurman and Errol Spence, and you know, I think that's about the two. I think Kell Brook was a bit like that, but Kell Brook wasn't very successful. But you know, he used to use it to his advantage as well. I think the same thing applies to Sean Porter. Forgive me. Sean Porter, yeah. So for me, I'm not going to say the jury's out. I think obviously he's got a big future ahead of him, unless something goes wrong. I don't, you know, these fighters that are not very articulate, I just don't fuck with that. I think you got to be, you know, there's got to be something else that you have that works for you. I think a lot of nowadays, right, you got all these fighters, and it's almost as if like, they're just terrible at communicating. They're just really, really bad. It's like, I don't know. I think we should have passed that stage right now where an athlete just cannot talk properly. I think in basketball, you get a lot of these athletes and they can actually express themselves properly and express themselves, you know, because it's a high, you have to give these intense interviews. But when it's boxing, I swear, Jerome, I was listening to him, he just sounded a bit remedial. I'm sorry, it is what it is. You get it with Tank, but you know, it could also be because they are being, they're being prepped in a way that makes sure that they stay completely and utterly to the script of what, you know, in terms of what they say. He said like, yeah, well, I'm looking for a fight. Mr. Big Fish is here. That's Errol Spence and so on. I don't know. But anyway, I'm not going to poo-poo on him. I think he looks the business. But then again, I also have to observe the fact that he has some advantages going in. And the knockout that he just had here, I'm not impressed with it because it was borderline illegal. He's much bigger than the guy. It is what it is. It's just, it's a highlight reel, and that's about it. It's not impressive to me. He said he was going to do it anyway. He said he was going to go looking for the knockout, and that's more or less what he got. So,
So Boots, what happens now? Obviously, everybody's hoping to see Errol Spence here tonight fight Bud Crawford. You're probably going to move up into a mandatory position should they get that fight on. What would you like to do now in the interim as next?
Anybody right now can get it right now, but I'm the IBF number one, you know, contender, and I think Mr. Big Fish in here is so it's time to go fishing.
Well, there's Errol right there.
We still running the city, and I did a whole lot, nigga.
Like, what?
I can't leave without city. I just spend it until I get dizzy. We smoke no one mixed out with the Benji. Scream up in Tennessee, popping us. Is he popping the titty? Y'all be pulling me left, but y'all know I'm the one. Like, they gon' put in no fun. I can't level no switch. I'ma level my gun. Like, and it's hot like the sun. Gang bitch to the back, I'ma bitch to the front. That's on bogus, we do this for fun. Gang bitch to the back, I'ma go to the front. That's on gang bitch, we do this for fun. Y'all be pulling me left, but y'all know I'm the one. Like, they gon' put in no fun. I can't level no switch. I'ma level my gun. Like, but it's hot like the sun. Gang bitch to the back, I'ma bitch to the front. That's on bogus, we do this for fun. Gang bitch to the back, I'ma go to the front. That's on gang bitch, we do this for fun. And I know I thought I saw him in court.
Like,
that nigga bitch. Catch me showing remorse.
Like,
he rap like a killer and all his songs.
So like,
Tom smoking his dad's and he didn't perform.
No, like, I didn't perform. And I did some more bitch with my chain. Like, he gon' hit a whole lot of shots. Since 13, I've been throwing that thing. And I suppose that thing won't pop. Living like he think don't spend no more.
But if I don't spend, won't up that score. Like, everybody don't stop, don't pass that ball. Like, we keep showing to that nigga fall. Like, and I put my gang on the map.
For sure.
I do this for the side. Like, scream my BT by a pussy get wet. Like, we've been beefing for years and nobody touched me. Like, this shit'll get ugly. Switching my dick, she be dying to fuck me. Like, she be dying to fuck me. And we all getting parts, we be screaming out money. Like, we be screaming out.
Like, suck my dick, like, what am I moving? I ain't never do shit. Like,
I'ma knock so big. Shit'll be booming and not down the fence. Like,